As you know that we are dealing with the chapter 4 multiplication. Till now we have learned main concepts in this chapter, that is multiplication by 2 digit number, 3 digit number, right? Also we have learned multiplication by tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, okay? So now we are going to learn today, we are going to start the multiplication word problems, the daily examples which are related with our daily life. Such examples we are going to learn. Okay, so in our daily life we face many such situations where we have to use this multiplication or process of multiplication. Okay, so which are such situations or how to use multiplication to calculate such in such situation, that we are going to learn today. Okay, see here the first problem in practice 4.8. You can open your textbook on practice 4.8. Okay, see the first problem. Aman has 7 purses. Aman has 7 purses. Okay, each purse contains 18 coins. Each purse contains 18 coins. That means in each purse, every purse, there are 18 coins. Okay, such 7 purses are there. How many coins are there in all the purses taken together? That the question is, if all those 7 purses are taken together, then how many coins will be there? That we have to find. Okay, so see here, if you observe this, the coins in one purse or each purse are given, that is in one purse there are 7 coins, in one purse there are 18 coins. Okay, such 7 purses are there. So 18, so like 7 times 18. If you take all 7 purses together, then 7 times 18 means how many total coins will be there. That we have to find. Okay. So first of all, we will write what is given. What is given? Number of purses are given. Number of coins in each purse. Number of coins in each purse. How many number of coins are there in each purse? See, each purse contains 18 coins. That means in each purse there are 18 coins. In each purse there are 18 coins. So I have written here number of coins in each purse is equal to 18. This is given. What we have to find? How many coins are there in all the purses together? All the purses means all 7 purses. So we have to find number of coins in each, number of coins in 7 purses. Number of coins in each purse are 18 and number of coins in 7 purses we have to find. That is, see, given, this is given, right? This is given. Given means where we know that in each purse there are 18 coins, but we don't know. What we don't know? In total 7 purses, how many coins will be there? That we don't know. That is, in front of it I have written question mark. So that means we have to find it. Okay. So given for each. Given for each. Each indicates 1. Given for 1. Asking means question mark. Asking for 7. Given for 1. Asking for 7. 7 means many. Okay. And when there is given for 1. And asking for many. Asking for means we have to find it. Asking for many. Such situation is there, given for 1 and asking for many. If this situation is there, then which operation we have to do? We have to do multiplication. Okay, given for 1, asking for many. Such situation is there, then we have to find, we have to do the multiplication. Okay, so see here, given for 1, asking for many. So To find total number of coins in 7 pulses, what we have to do? We have to multiply 18 by 7. So let's multiply 18 multiplied by 7. 7 8s are 56. 6 will come down, 5 will be carried. And then 7 on the 7 plus 5, 12. So 126. One total 126 coins are there in each total 7 purses. Okay. So there are 126 coins in 7 purses. Okay. 126 coins are there. 18, 18, 18, 18, 18. If you add 18 7 times, then also you will get 126. And you know that repeated addition of same number is nothing but multiplication. So directly 18, instead of adding 18 7 times, directly multiply 18 by 7, you will get the answer. Okay. Come to the next problem. See you. Shyam walks 9 km every day. What distance does he walk in 17 days? See, Shyam walk 9 km every day. Every day he walks in the morning, suppose. He go for the jogging. And he walks 9 km every day. Okay, 9 km every day. What distance does he walk in 17 days? So this is given. Given for one day. Distance covered by, distance walked by Shyam. Distance walked in, walked every day. Every day. What is that? 9 km. 9 km. Every day he walks 9 km. Okay. Then how much distance he will cover or how much distance he will walk? Distance walked. Distance walked in 17 days. Okay, distance walked every day 9 km. Every day he walked 9 km distance. Okay, then within 17 days, in 17 days, how much distance he will cover? Same here, given for every day. Every day indicates 1. Every day means 1 day, right? So every single day he walks 9 km distance. Then in 17 days, how much distance he will cover? Given for one, asking for many. Again, same situation. Which operation we are going to do? Multiplication. So let's multiply 17 into 9. 17 into 9 are 153. Directly also you can write. 9 7 is 63. See here. 9 1 9 and 6 15. 153. Okay, so Shyam walks 153 km. Distance is counted in the kilometer, measured in the kilometer in 17 days. So if he is walking 9 km every day, if he is walking 9 km every day in the 17 days, he can walk 153 km. Okay? So now pause this video and write these two word problems in your notebook. After this, you will learn two more word problems. Okay? See the problem number 3. A battalion has 1560 soldiers. How many soldiers will 16 battalions have? You know, our soldiers are there on the border to protect us, right? To save us from the enemy. So there are battalions of the soldiers. Battalions is what? Group. Group of soldiers are called battalions, okay? So in a battalion, one battalion, there are 1560 soldiers, right? So this can be written in the given. Soldiers in a battalion. soldiers in a battalion. A indicates one. Okay. So how many soldiers are there? One battalion. A battalion. 1560 soldiers are there in a battalion. Okay. And we have to find, this is given, okay, and what we have to find, how many soldiers will 16 such or 16 battalions have. So we have to find soldiers in 16 battalion. Okay. So given, again here say given for O. O indicates 1. Given for 1. Asking for 16. 16 means many. Many means what? More than 1. Okay. So asking for many. Given for 1. Asking for many. Which operation we are going to do? Multiplication, right? So let's multiply 1560. This is the number of soldiers in 1 battalion. Multiply by total number of battalions. That is 16 battalions. Okay, and we, you know the table of 16, right? 16 zeros are 0. 16 6 are 96. Okay, so 6 will come down, 9 will be carried. 16 5s are, what is 16 5s are? 16 5s are 80. Plus 9, 80 plus 9, 89. So this 9 will come down, 8 will be carried. Okay, and 16 plus 8, 24. So 1 stays 100, 1000 take 1000. So there are 24,960 soldiers. In 16 battalions. Okay. There are 24,960 soldiers in 16 battalions together. Okay. Next. Next is, see same. Each carton has. Carton means box. Box of wood, wooden box. Each carton has 2526 soap cakes means soap. Okay, how many soap cakes will a consignment of 93 such cartons have? In each carton, each box, there are 2526 soap cakes. Okay, so soap cakes in each carton. Each, every, all these words indicates one. So takes in each carton how many? 2526. Okay. And we have to find how many soap cakes will a consignment? Consignment means what? If we have given order, that is from consignment. In consignment of 93 such cartons, suppose one shopkeeper has given order of 93 such cartons having 2526 soap cakes in one each. Okay, so it's 93 such cartons. How what will be the total number of soap cakes that we have to find? So soap cakes. Soap cakes in 93 cartons is what? Soap cakes in 93 cartons are how many? Okay. So that we will find here also, see given for each. Each indicates one. Each indicates one. And asking for 93. 93 means many. Okay. So given for one, asking for many. Which operation we are going to do?
Yes.
Multiplication. So 2526, that is number of soap cakes in each carton, multiply by number of cartons. How many number of cartons are there? 93. Now see here, multiplication by two digit number more than 20. So we are going to use which method?
Yes.
We are going to use long multiplication method, that is we multiply by individual digit. First multiply by 3. 3 6 are 18. Then 8 will come down, 1 will be carried. 3 2s are 6. Plus 1? 7. 3 5s are 15, right? So 5 will come down, 1 will be carried. 3 2s are 6 and 1? 7. Now we are going to multiply by 10 space digit, that is 9. So in the 1 space put 0. The curve is carried. 9 6 are 54. 4 will come down, 5 will be carried. 9 2s are 18 and 5 23. So 3 will come down, 2 will be carried. 9 5s are 45 plus 2 47. 7 will come down, 4 will be carried. Okay. And then 9 2s are 18, 18 and 4, 22. Let's add this. 8 plus 0, 8. 7 plus 4, 11. 1 will come down, 1 will be carried. 5 plus 8 and 1, 9. 7 plus 7, 14. 1 will be carried. 2 plus 1, 3. And here 2. So the car. The number of soap cakes in 93 cartons are, so there are 2,34,918 soap cakes in 93 cartons. Understood? So in this way we have to solve the word problems which are based on the multiplication. First of all, in exam you will not be given that yes, this is a word problem of multiplication, so solve that. No, the word problems will be given mixed. Some word problems will have addition, subtraction, multiplication and division also, okay? So you have to understand the situation, you have to identify the situation, you have to by yourself you have to acknowledge which operation you have to do there. Okay, so understand this situation. When there is given for one, asking for many, you have to do the multiplication. Okay, so now pause this video and write this in your notebook. If you have any doubt regarding these word problems, you can ask. And in this practice 4.8, 5th word problem you have to solve by yourself. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.